Hi friends, welcome back to Angular Hero to Superhero series. If you are a beginner trying to learn Angular, there is another series, Angular 0 to Hero, in which I have explained all the basic concepts. You can find the link in the description. In this Angular series, Hero to Superhero, I am focusing on advanced concepts. In this video, I am going to explain how we can inform something to user on screen using some third-party libraries. Let's start. First, I am going to show you how we can use sweetalert in an Angular application. Sweetalert is used to show a message to an user. Assume an user is trying to create an account. Once the account is created successfully, we can use sweetalert to inform the user that the account has been created successfully. Also, in some scenario, there may be some error. That also, we may need to inform the user. Or we can use sweetalert to get some confirmation from user. There are many use cases like this. Let me show you a few examples. I have created this Angular application. Here I have a button. On clicking this, I need to tell something to user. Actually, I can use a simple alert. But this is not fancy. Let me use sweetalert. First, we need to install sweetalert in our application. When we install a third-party library, we need to first read their documentation to find the compatible version of the library which we need to choose to install. Otherwise, we may face some unwanted dependency issues. Also, for most of the jQuery libraries, you can find the suitable wrapper for Angular. NGX sweetalert 2 is the Angular wrapper for sweetalert. And this is the documentation of Angular sweetalert. Here, you can find the version compatibility table. I am using Angular version 13. And so, according to this table, I need to install version 11 of sweetalert. And if you see here, we need to install sweetalert also as dependency. So let me copy this command. And add the version here. Okay, let's install. It is installed. Let me start the server. And let me go to the app module and import the sweetalert2 module. I can use the for loop to add any global options, but we are going to use individual options. Now let me go to the app component. Here I can import sval from sweetalert2. Sval is the namespace which is having all the needed utility function for sweetalert. It is also mentioned in the documentation. In this Angular documentation, approaches like directives, services, etc. are mentioned. But I am going to follow the documentation of original sweetalert, which is easy to implement. So, inside the onSuccess function, I can simply call the fire method from sval. If I click this button, we can see the alert. But this does not have any message. I can add one. Like this. Now we can see this. This is actually a title. We can see that here. First parameter is title. Second one is HTML, where we can have some message. And the third one is icon. So, let this be a message. Let me add a title first and then an icon. Now we can see the success alert. Similarly, let me create an error alert. Like this. Let me also create a warning. Okay. You can refer the documentation for more options. Here we have a confirm option. Let's try this. Let me create a button first and call a function. Inside the function, I can call the fire method from sval, but this time let me use this. We don't want a cancel button. Let me also change the title, message and button text. And so we can see this. We can use the then method to get the response from user. So if I console log this result, we can see this. And so based on the result, if needed, I can show another alert like this. Hope you understood. I request you to play around with the other options also. Next, I am going to show you how we can use another library called toastr in our Angular application. The Angular wrapper for toastr is ngx toastr. Let me open the documentation first. So from this dependencies table, we can understand the version we need to install is this one. Let me copy this command and add version in that. Okay, it is installed. Also, we need to install @angular/animations. So let me run this command also. Okay, done. And then we need to add the toastr CSS. Let's follow this approach as we are using CLI. Let me open the angular.json and let me add this line. That's it. Let me start the server. Now let me open the app module and import the toastr module. Now we can start using toastr in this application. First, let me create a button to trigger the toastr. And let me create the function. To use the toastr, I can inject the toastr service like this. And inside the function, I can call the respective method from toastr service. First, let me call success and pass some message. So when we click this, we can see a success toastr. Similarly, let me create an error toastr. Now I need to call the error method. So we can see this. If you need to add a title, we can do that. So we can see a title also. This is also having many options. We can see that in the documentation. Let's explore the position class. Let me give bottom right instead of top right. Now we can see the toastr is showing in the bottom. The default timeout is 5 seconds. I can increase that to 8 seconds. So if I click both the buttons, we can see error toastr is coming in the bottom and success toastr is coming in the top. Also, success toastr is closed in 5 seconds, but the error toastr is closed only after 8 seconds. Here also, I am requesting you to play around with other options. Hope you understood about how to implement toastr using ngx toastr library. But in case if you like to achieve the same functionality without using the third party library like ngx toastr, you can check this video. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.